Hey guys, Pastor Marcus Kelly, and welcome to Big Children's Church. This video is for grades 4th through 6th grade, roughly. It starts with a time of worship, then there's some devotional material, some skits, and some testimony, and it's a really excellent resource. And we're glad to be able to offer this free resource for you guys, because even though we're going through this time that we're going through, and we're not able to meet like we want to, we haven't forgotten about you, your family, your children, and I want you to know that we're with you, we're praying for you, and if there's anything that we can do during this time to minister to your family, feel free to reach out and contact us. But right now, I hope that you enjoy this time. Again, 4th through 6th grade. God bless you.
You guys, we're at church at home. How cool is that? My name is Jesse, and I want to get us straight into worship. Worship is where we are spending time with God. Normally, we kind of do it as a group. You get to be at home with your family and your dog and your goldfish. So don't get weird about it. Like, you can worship from home just like you do at church every single week. Except now, if you wanted to, you could worship like with your shoes on your hands and no one would judge you. So worship God however you see fit. Let's go.
Find our identity in the things or the people that are around us. You know, we can find our identity in our friends that we hang out with, or maybe it's the sports we play, or in our ability to perform. Anything that we're really great at can easily become our identity. But you know, the problem with that is that the minute that that changes or it's taken away from us, we lose our identity. The Bible actually tells us that we're made in the image of God. We're made to love and to worship Him. And because God never changes, our identity is safe and secure in Him. And so we can worship Him from that truth today, knowing that we are who we are because of who Christ is. Worshiping God isn't what we do. It's a part of who we are. So let's worship Him today, knowing that we know who we are because of who Christ is.
Stone walls and every end.
Guys, worship at home. That's how the early church used to do it. They used to all meet together in a home and have worship. So sing out loud. You're allowed to dance. You're allowed to sing. If you're not sitting with someone right now, that's technically how church is supposed to happen. So why don't you go ahead and grab someone? Yeah, I'm actually gonna wait. Go ahead. Okay, so I can't actually see whether you did it or not, but I'm really hoping you did. Before we get into the Loop Show, Ricky and Jamie wanted me to ask you a question. What do you think is the last thing that a superhero thinks about before they go to bed at night? I was thinking like Superman. He probably thinks about how buff he is, or he's like x-ray visioning into the fridge to see, you know, if he can make pancakes tomorrow. What do you think? So that was our time. Now we have to go straight into the Loop Show. Y'all, we just wasted a bunch of time talking about superheroes. But to be honest, my inner talk, the last thing I think about before I go to bed at night, isn't always so positive. Let's see what Ricky and Jamie think about.
Want to see the first time that we met each other?
I'm not sure I do.
Hang on for the loop!
3, 2, 1.
I'm Ricky.
I'm Jamie. Wait, I can do that better. Let's go again.
Okay, I'm Ricky.
I'm Jamie. Ugh, hold on. Okay, I want to get this just right, so let's go one more time.
I'm Ricky.
I'm Jamie. I'm Jamie.
I'm Jamie.
The show must go on.
I'm Jamie.
Let's go again.
Jamie, I think we got it.
I just have this inner voice that's telling me that I could do it better.
Oh, like an inner critic.
Yes. You have one too?
Yes. His name is Britton, and he is relentless. I mean, we all have an inner critic. It's that voice inside your head that keeps on nitpicking at every single little thing you do.
My little voice, I haven't named it yet, but just reminds me of all the mistakes that I make.
Yeah, how we view ourselves can affect what we say and do.
We've got to learn how to control our inner voice.
Good thing we're in the Loop Show control room.
I'm sure we can find something around here.
Yes, maybe a life hack that teaches us never to make mistakes.
We do have a life hack, but it has a slightly different approach.
Okay.
Today we are going to be talking about how to fail. So I'm an actor, and in acting you get a lot of no's. And to me, every no would feel like a little mini failure. And I would do everything I could to avoid failing. I had a fail phobia. Most of all, because I felt like I was the only one. Which leads me into tip number one on how to deal with failure, and it's to realize that everyone fails. I want you to think of one person right now who you really, really admire or who you think is really successful. You got him? Okay. Well, guess what? They failed. Probably a million times in their life, and the failures that they've overcome in the past is probably how they got to where they are today. So if you failed before, if you're failing right now, don't worry about it. Cut yourself some slack. Don't get down and out because it happens to everyone and you're doing great. Tip number two is what I like to call failing forward. Now, what in the world is failing forward, Nicole? Well, I'm glad you asked. Failing forward, in my personal opinion, is failing but not letting it take you out of the game and instead leaning into it. You know that old saying, don't look back because you're not going that way? The same rule applies here. If you failed before, don't get hung up on it. It happened and you can't change the past. But what you can change is the future. And the way that you can use failure to your advantage is to learn from what happened, take that knowledge and the experience, and apply it to life later on. A lot of times I feel like people see failure as a negative thing, but if taken advantage of correctly, AKA failing forward instead of letting it get you down, failure can actually be a weapon for you to use instead of the enemy. And number three, here goes. If you've made a mistake, don't panic. If at first you don't succeed, try again. Now I know it's super corny, I know your parents have probably told it to you a million times, but it's really true. As long as you keep trying, keep pushing forward, keep believing, then you have no choice but to succeed in the end. So, let's do a little recap of how to fail. Number one, happens to everyone. It's just a part of life. Number two, fail forward. Failing is okay. What's not okay is letting it take you out of the game. Anytime you fail, understand why it failed, what was missing, and what you can do better next time. And number three, don't panic and jump right back in. So the next time a failure happens, remember these 3 tips and you'll be good to go. And I'll see you next time.
We learned something new today. We learned something new.
My inner critic, well, you know, it sounds like it vomits. You can't put out a fire like all the other firefighters and...
It usually sounds like my mom telling me that I shouldn't do something.
My inner voice tells me I'm not good enough.
What?
My hair's not long enough. It's
crazy.
Not silky enough. I don't look like those other giraffe people.
I don't know if you know this about T-Rex, but we have little arms, okay? I just, I said it.
When I look on social media and I see these really pretty girls, it makes me a little paranoid. Do you think I'm pretty?
Yeah, I think you're real pretty, ma'am.
Oh my goodness, the block is talking.
My inner voice kind of sounds like my dad. He tells me that I can do anything I put my mind to.
So your inner voice is kind of nice.
Yeah, pretty confident.
I don't like to be still at all because that's when my inner critic is the loudest.
I don't like to talk about it, but my inner critic makes me feel really insecure about my long neck.
Oh. That's so funny that you say that, because that's one of my insecurities. My inner critic tells me that I have a short neck.
What?
I know.
Our inner voices make us feel bad about the way that God made us.
There's all kinds of people that probably feel the same way and think the same things like we do and have inner critics tell them things that really aren't true.
Roar! I think we need to ignore our inner critics sometimes and listen to our friends.
I agree. I think you have a wonderful neck.
Well, I think you have a wonderful neck.
All right, so we are going to be looking at our auditions for the Loop Show.
Yeah, I'm super excited, and I'm also like a little nervous.
Yeah, we're gonna start with Jamie's audition.
Oh boy. Okay, so this is my initial submission. Let's see it.
Hey Loop, my name is Jamie, and I am currently living in Edmond, Oklahoma. I graduated from the University of Central Oklahoma back in 2010, and have been performing professionally
doing a lot of hand motions
since 2011. And I can play the recorder. I can also play the piano. And I also
I can
work
play the recorder
professionally on stage. I've worked with alpacas, zebus, mini donkeys,
yes,
llamas.
And I have worked with a lot of live animals.
Maybe sing one of your favorite songs for me.
Okay, so we were asked we were asked to interview people. And I think one of the ideas was they were like, you can ask them to sing a song with you. And so I found a squirrel. But yeah, so this is me trying to get the squirrel to sing.
That's okay.
I am glad that I interviewed the squirrel. I think I interview a statue later too.
That's a solid audition. So what's your inner critic telling you now?
Inner critic is saying that I use too many hands and that my nails, I painted my nails like bright red. And so it was kind of distracting, but you know, I don't know.
Okay, here we go. Here's my audition.
That's some necklace.
Thank you.
That's a statement necklace.
It is a... Oh, I'm so nervous.
Hello, my name is Ricky, and welcome to The Loop Show, the only show that keeps you in the loop. Now, one of my favorite things.
We should use that. That was good.
Thanks. So I remember they were like, just tell us a story about a time that you, I think it was like, made a bad mistake or like, was it the right thing to do?
And which one to choose from?
Right. Hmm. So many. And and I think that's what I'm talking about.
One of my favorite things of all time is the 1987 TV show Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Brotherhood,
of course,
Ninjutsu Action.
You bring up the Ninja Turtles.
And pizza. Aww. And one thing I wanted more than anything was to become a ninja master. But unfortunately, my parents, they didn't sign me up for karate classes, but I really, really
You're so
wanted
comfortable
to.
In front of the camera.
So,
it's really nice.
False. I
really?
Was so uncomfortable. I was just like, okay. Like, when I get nervous, like I am now, the back of my ears and my neck get really, really hot, and so that was what was happening.
Oh, ouch!
What I ended up doing is being a self-trained ninja master. You do get to learn that jumping off your bed and trying to do a kick without proper padding can result in pain.
This right here, that's where I sustained that injury from.
Okay, one word that your inner critic would use to describe your video.
I wish I was more confident, I guess.
Well, it's funny because so you didn't notice my nails, and I didn't feel the same way that you did about your video. I thought you seemed really comfortable in front of the camera.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, so we can't always trust our inner critic.
Yeah.
Question: is it selfish to love myself?
Answer: putting yourself at the center of the universe and putting God second is a sin. That's selfish. But it's not selfish to put God first and love yourself the way He loves you. Give your thoughts the same compassion and grace that God gives you.
In the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 8.
Think about the things you think about.
Finally, brothers and sisters, think about such things.
Whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things.
Think about the things you think about.
Think about such things.
Think about the things you think about.
Whatever is true and noble, whatever is right and pure, whatever is lovely and admirable, whatever is excellent, praiseworthy, think about such things.
Think about the things you think about.
Think about such things.
Think about the things you think about.
Think about such things.
Finally, brothers and sisters,
think about
such things.
Think about the things you think.
Now we're going to see the first time that we met.
We didn't know what we were going to do.
Okay.
So today we're going to be sharing some ideas worth sharing. I was thinking that an idea worth sharing would be the way that I eat grilled cheese sandwiches. Ooh. I sprinkle sugar on top.
Sprinkle sugar on your grilled cheese. It's so good.
I completely forgot about that. Look at my amazement.
Yes, he really thinks it's a good idea.
I'm like, wait, what? This is a game changer.
I just feel like our dynamic was like this from the very beginning, and mm-hmm. it's still like that. And I love it.
Why, hello.
Why, hello.
Winston Churchill.
So in this challenge, we had to pretend to be Winston Churchill while expanding into like a massive blueberry.
Well, yes, because I am the original Winston Churchill.
Oh, I do believe you are mistaken.
What is this?
These are my suspenders.
And we completely forgot that we were supposed to be expanding blueberries at this point.
Oh, we did. You're right.
Oh, you're down.
Out of the way, please.
Oh,
no. You're the new Winston Churchill. I have just accepted defeat.
He had no clue really who Winston Churchill was. We were willing to try.
Yes.
Like, and I think that that's a big thing. Like, all of the challenges that we do on The Loop Show, they are challenges. They're not, like, easy things that we know we can win at.
I feel like sometimes our inner critics make us feel bad about ourselves or like we're not good enough to do something. But just like you're seeing in this video, you have friends that can help you along and help you to accomplish whatever it is that your inner voice is telling you that you can't accomplish.
Yeah. I'm glad that we get to go through these challenges together.
Together.
As a follower of Jesus, you are called to show compassion to others. You are called, I am called, we are all called to show compassion. And that even includes showing compassion to our enemies. Now, based on all of that, it would make sense that God also wants us to show compassion to ourselves. It can be really difficult to show love to others when we don't show that same love and compassion to ourselves. I know this to be true because there definitely have been times when I wasn't very good at loving myself. So if you're trying to love others, but you're not really good at loving yourself well, it's honestly kind of like trying to describe the taste of pizza to someone when you've never even had a slice yourself. I want you to check in with yourself. Are you believing the lie that God couldn't love you? Here's a thought that you can hold on to when you face that inner critic. You cannot get outside of God's love for you. You just can't. There's nothing you can do to escape His love. God's love for you is not based on what you do or what you did. Remind yourself that God loves you, and you should love you too. Speak this over yourself. Tell this to yourself. Say, I am loved by God. This is an excellent and praiseworthy thought to chew on. Now, if you're really struggling with loving yourself and you need help, please find someone to talk to. You can be open, you can be honest, and you need to know that it is okay not to be okay. And please always remember that you can't get outside of God's love for you.
I'm glad we met, Jamie.
Me too. I think you're the bee's knees.
I think you're the cat's pajamas.
Peachy keen, jelly bean. You know, sometimes it's good to think about the things you think about.
Whatever is praiseworthy or excellent, think of such things this week.
Listen, you can't get outside of God's love for you, no matter what your inner critic says.
And until next time,
enjoy the ride!
Okay, wait, I can do that better. Enjoy the ride! Nope, that was too...
Enjoy the ride!
Sorry, I did a weird thing with my hands. Enjoy the ride!
Oh, I missed it.
If your inner critic tells you that God doesn't love you, that's just not true. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that your love is so much bigger than our own inner critic, our own inner doubts, and the things that we think about ourselves that are so much less than what you think about us. Because when you see us, God, you see someone that is loved. You see a masterpiece. You see a son and a daughter. And I pray that we will choose to see ourselves the same way that you see us, full of grace and full of truth. Now, still in an attitude of prayer, I know that there are many of us who we've done things in our past that we just can't seem to get over. These things that have hurt others, ourselves, or even the heart of God, those things are called sin. And sin has created this gap between us and God. But here's the good news, is that God's grace covers the gap. That God, in his love and his grace for you and for me, wanted to help us understand that the voice in our head isn't true of who we are. And so what he did is he sent his son Jesus to this earth 2,000 years ago, so that anybody who believes in him could be forgiven of their sins and experience life and life to the full. And Jesus, he lived a perfect life and he died a brutal death for your sins and for mine. And then 3 days later, God raised him from the dead so that anybody who believes in Jesus would be saved. They would be made new and that they would be made right with God. And today, God is offering his grace to you. He's offering you forgiveness. He's offering you hope and he is offering you life. All you have to do is say yes to following Jesus. And if today is the day where you say yes to Jesus, then simply lift your hand right now. All over the place, we know that people are saying yes to Jesus for the first time. And we're gonna pray alongside them in support. So repeat after me. Dear Jesus, forgive me. I'm turning from my sin. I'm turning toward you. I need your love. I need your grace. And I need your mercy. I give you my life. In Jesus' name. Amen. We are so proud of you for making that choice. It's the best decision you could make in your entire life. So please make sure you talk to somebody about it. Tell a friend, tell a family member, tell your small group leader so they can celebrate with you and help you better understand what it looks like to follow Jesus.
So if you made that choice today, first of all, massive congratulations. The biggest congratulations. I wish you weren't through a screen right now because I would want to give you a huge high five. Congratulations. I want you to talk to an adult, though. Talk to an adult that you trust about following Jesus and what that means for you. Guys, Loop Show's over here, but it continues on in the YouVersion Bible app. There's a Bible plan dedicated to this right now. It's called Think About the Things You Think About. Go into the app or go onto Bible.com and search Think About the Things You Think About. It'll take you straight there. It's gonna give you a whole week of stuff to go through. So to finish up, we're gonna have some discussion questions on the screen. They're gonna come right, they interrupted me, huh? You can't even see me right now. Okay, I'll just, go ahead, talk about these questions.